Nikita Malik is senior researcher in radicalisation and terrorism at the Henry Jackson Society. She's with me in the studio. I mean, as Frank was saying there, in military terms, this makes little difference to IS, but in propaganda terms, probably quite damaging.
Of course. I mean, we see here that Sally Jones represents a convert, a white woman who went from the UK. A lot of her propaganda was specifically tailored to other young women. And she, of course, married an extremely well-recognized propagandist as well. Junaid Hussain was one of the forefront people who was also looking at cyber attacks and logistical ways of doing attacks. So the fact that she's gone makes very little difference. What I think matters is who will they use to replace her now? Will there be somebody else, a female figurehead, who will be the next something al-Britani? I think it remains to be seen what that message and how it will be conveyed.
Nikita, talk to us about ISIS and how they've recruited women, because it's pretty unusual, even in terms of Islamic terrorist groups, this recruitment and the profiling of women that they've had.
Absolutely. Islamic State was the first organization to actively put out advertisements for women. It created a state where women could join and be part of a family. And something that Sally Jones also was very good at in terms of propaganda was promoting her child as a forefront child soldier. And that was a very good example to other women who were going out to join Islamic State. And as recently as a few weeks ago, we've seen for the first time the Taliban come out with a magazine advertising for women and their role there. So Islamic State really set some kind of example in using women to groom and recruit other women.
And what was the kind of appeal that they offered women? And we saw it with the young girls, of course, who went from London as well. What was it that they used to hook them into the organisation and get them to go to the caliphate?
The appeal was extremely ideological in nature. So although a lot of these young women knew that their lives there were going to be extremely difficult and they'd probably be married to a stranger, the ideology was still very much that they were contributing to a state-building project. Their afterlife would be very good. They were leaving behind the kuffar lands of, say, the United Kingdom or the US, filled with disbelievers, and actually going to a legitimate Muslim state. So all of these aspects, very theological, particularly in Western and English-based propaganda, to attract these young girls to go and become essentially the wives and baby-making machines of the next generation of fighters.
It's an extraordinary story. Nikita, thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.